The story of Akita the dog, a dog's tale. Have you ever heard of Hachiko? No? If you ever traveled to Japan, then you will listen to the story of Akita. Hachiko is a knight in shining armor to the Japanese, a dog that is famed to be the pinnacle of loyalty and love. There have been various movies about him. Managed to crop up a bronze statue next to Shibuya train station in Tokyo, where every day swarms of folks snap their photographs with the dog. Hollywood has made a movie about Hachiko the dog. There is even a statue of him in Rhode Island in the USA, where the American version of the film was made. So, you may wonder why the Hachiko story is so noteworthy. Welcome to yet another video of our channel, Epic Mojo. In today's video, we bring you the story of Akita the dog, a dog's tale. Before we begin, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, jump to that subscribe button and hit that notification bell. All right, let's get back into the video. Hachiko was a dog recognized for his infinite attachment and affection for his master. In 1923, Hachiko the dog was born on a farm and was later adopted by Hida Saburo Yuno, a university professor of agriculture in Tokyo, Japan. Even after his tragic, sudden, crushing death, Hachiko waited at Shibuya train station every afternoon until his owner returned from work. While it's been nearly a century since his birth, the touching, real story of Hachiko has given way to children's books, statues, and movies. The Bequest of Hachiko. While Yuno was not in the market for a pup, Hachiko was given unexpectedly as a present from his student. An esteemed scholar and authority on agriculture, civil engineering in Japan, Yuno was praised for his field contributions. Even though he was a dog lover, as he owned 16 dogs in his lifetime, he'd never had a pup like Hachiko. The two would handle a bitter beginning, but it only succumbs to strengthen their fondness of each other. An unforgettable bond is formed. Every morning, Hachiko accompanies Yuno to the station where the two would part ways for the day. Yuno would board the train for work. Hachiko would come to the station to greet his beloved companion at the end of each day, even if it's rain or snow or sunny. This routine continued for years and provided constant comfort and unwavering friendship to the other. A turn of events tragically took curtain in their relationship. Hachiko waved bye to his friend Professor Yuno, who boarded the train for the last time on May 21st, 1925. During a lecture, the 53-year-old professor suffered a fatal brain hemorrhage. But even Hachiko couldn't predict that it would be the last day they ever saw the professor again. Well, Hachiko had no idea about this, so the loyal dog continued to wait for his master's return. Every day, like clockwork, when the train would appear, so would Hachi, searching for Yuno. Yuno's wife didn't keep Hachiko. Yuno and Yeiko, his wife, were not legally married. Yuno was promised to a woman from a prominent family by the Yuno family. He fell in love with Yeiko. As his family disapproved of their union, Yuno and Yeiko decided to go away to live together. She hadn't had any legal rights to the house, so she was forced to go live with an acquaintance when Yuno died. If you think practically, it was tough for her to keep a large dog during these shifts. So, she sent him to live with an acquaintance who lived in the eastern part of Tokyo. Hachiko demonstrates his fantastic loyalty. Despite the distance, Hachiko would repeatedly run back to his former house around Shibuya Station. As he was concerned for the dog's health and safety, the professor's former gardener, Kobayashi, took Hachiko in, having known the dog for years. The dog craved for his owner. The bond was proving to be unbreakable. In fact, the bond was so plastered in time that Hachiko spent the rest of his life searching for Yuno, who passed away. Morning and evening, he arrived at the station, but Yuno never came back. Hachiko made headlines. Hachiko was not stray after all. Locals in the station presumed that he was, practically thinking, why else would a dog be there by himself? Some of the employees took him for granted. Children used to tease and taunt, and even they would paint his face with a mustache, while vendors were even harsher to spill water on Hachiko, hoping it would make him leave and not return. He was seen as a wandering dog, a pest, and even as an unwanted beast. Hirokichi Saito, one of Yuno's students, recognized Hachiko and tried to stop the abuse by contacting the local media outlet on October 4th, 1932. They published a story. The story's headline is pinned as, "The Tale of a Poor Old Dog Patiently Waiting for 7 Years for His Dead Owner." Shibuya Station Hachiko Statues. Impressed by Hachiko's proud appearance and calmness, Ando, a sculptor in 1933, saw Hachiko for the first time at the station. He saw the chance to design a new kind of art as a tribute to the gentle dog hero, whose story was fascinating. Ando molded a plaster statue of Hachiko for the Imperial Fine Arts Academy exposition. In front of the ticket gate at Shibuya Station, a bronze statue was erected, with a poem inscribed on a banner with an honor, "Lines to a Loyal Dog." Hundreds of people arrived for the festive unveiling, including the grandchildren of Professor Yuno. Hachiko was also in attendance, wearing red and white scarves for the event, professed to capture the impact he had made. But what is fascinating is that all of this did not stop Hachiko from continuing to wait for Yuno's return. What changed is now that he was waiting with his new sculpture. Locals recall seeing Hachiko staring at the statue. During World War II, the statue was crashed to support the war efforts. Dismally, the sculptor was also killed during an air raid. Takeshi Ando, his son, in 1948 replicated the bronze statue for his father and Hachiko. The replication of the statue is often stated as a significant point in protecting the Akita breed from extinction, which has been seen declining post-war. Its legacy still stays on through statues, monuments, and sculptures. A statue of Hachiko with Professor Yuno at Tokyo University. These are some of the memories that still make us remember its legacy. Hachi, A Dog's Tale. It is a profoundly moving film. An American adaptation of the Japanese Akita is a loyal dog named Hachiko. The movie was inspired by Hachiko's true story and the friendship between Vicky Wong, the producer, and her dog. She managed to create a space to share Hachi's powerful story and all he represents with the world. Her mission is to promote compassion and acclaim for our cherished animal friends. It's a very peaceful film that quickly engages the viewers as it introduces a heroic dog. A man with a loving heart and idyllic setting. Lasse Hellström, a Swedish director, is the perfect choice to be at the helm of this immensely appealing tale of a dog's extraordinary devotion and affection to his human companion. The screenplay was written by Stephen P. Lindsay, relied on a movie that created one of the most loved stories in Japanese history. Everyone who watches the film, young or old, man or woman, from any background, shares an intangible response to Hachi's story, an emotional explosion of love and gratitude, an awakening to what truly stirs their soul. Their tale is gentle, played through a child explaining his grandfather's dog as his hero. Returning home one night by a train, college music professor Parker Wilson finds Nikita puppy, who has busted out of an unlabeled crate. The train station manager wants nothing to do with the dog, so Parker takes him home to his inexplicably irritated wife, Kate. Then Parker leaves the day unexpectedly, and Hachi begins his famous watchfulness. The locals realize what is happening, and the commuters begin leaving money and food. Soon, a newspaper article about the dog waits. The viewers out there have the same opinion about the dog who played Hachi. They are lovely to look at, and expresses in a cool, almost intellectual way that more promiscuous, affectionate breeds. Even though watching a dog wait continuously for days has its cinematic limitations, it is quickly reached. Furthermore, the viewers were stuck due to the nature of the film's theme, especially expressed as a boy's visibility of heroism. Hachi's powerful world ends with the master's loss. Emotionally or literally, he couldn't move on. He couldn't even see Kate as his master and transfer his love or fondness to her. At least in the Western terms, this makes his tale much more tragic than motivating. But it ensures that the viewers are definitely gonna cry their eyes out. Hachiko's tale, vision, and legacy live on because of his devotion and his beautiful soul. In a world of heartbreak and uncertainty, Hachiko reminds us that genuine, untangled love is the most expensive offering of all. His gentle, universal message continues to provoke tears and spur action. This compels us to consider the things that really matter most in our lives and makes us remember the importance of love and loyalty are the binding threads which can bring together an entire community. Well, did you put your heart and soul into Hachiko? Let us know in the comment section below. That's a wrap, and give this video a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.